Love and marriage, love and marriage, they go together like a horse and carriage. This I'll tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other.
Is Missy to be given to Anthony in marriage today?
Thank you.
Her mother and I.
All right, thank you. Can I have a seat? Awesome, all right, go ahead and hold hands if you guys want to. Dearly beloved, we are gathered together here in the sight of God and the presence of these witnesses to join together Anthony and Missy in holy matrimony. Marriage is an honorable estate instituted by the Creator in the time of creation for the well-being of mankind. It is safeguarded by the laws of Moses, affirmed by the words of the prophets, and hallowed by the teachings of our Lord Jesus Christ. Marriage is a union close and enduring, a relationship in which a man and a woman forsake all others to become one flesh. This abiding union illustrates the holy relationship between Christ and His church. Marriage is therefore not to be entered into by any lightly, but reverently, soberly, and in the fear of the Creator. You know, guys, when God created marriage, we see that in the Old Testament, we know that God created the whole world. And as He's creating all these things, every time He creates something, He says, this is good, this is good. Until all of a sudden He created something that was not good. In Genesis chapter 2, it says, the Lord said, it is not good for man to be alone. I will make a helper suitable for him. And so we see God create this wonderful image, this wonderful reflection of His creation, of who He is, and that is marriage. And it says, when Adam and Eve first saw each other, this is what the man said. He said, now this is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She will be called woman, for she was taken out of man. That is why man leaves his father and mother and is united to his wife, and they become one flesh. God has set you guys apart today to become something new, something different than the two of you separated from each other could be, and that is to create family. And it's my privilege to get to come and oversee this union between you two. And it's good to see the happiness on your faces. I would suggest a couple things to you, though. When God created the world, there's something wonderful in His image that marriage is supposed to reflect. And as you know, that it doesn't take long in the Bible to find out that man and woman were great together until one day they kind of messed everything up. And because they did, every one of us who's ever been married knows how what it means to mess it up. And you guys will probably have your share of issues as you go forward. But here's what I want to give you guys. Just two thoughts of what marriage is supposed to reflect and who God is. The one is that God is always faithful. And marriage is supposed to be something which reflects God's faithfulness. That you would be faithful to one another. And two, God is loving. He loves unconditionally. And you and I are to love our spouses with an unconditional love. That means we don't love if you do this or this or this. We love you because God has given each of you to one another. And so I would encourage you to remember those two things. I'd like to read a psalm as a blessing over both of you today. It's from the 36th Psalm. It says, "Your love, Lord, reaches to the heavens, your faithfulness to the skies. Your righteousness is like the highest mountain, your justice like the great deep. You, Lord, preserve both people and animals. How priceless is your unfailing love, O God. People take refuge in the shadow of your wings. They feast on the abundance of your house. You give them drink from your river of delights. For with you is the fountain of life, and in your light we see light." Can I pray for you guys? Pray with me. Heavenly Father, I just want to stop this afternoon before we take the wedding vows and consummate this marriage. I pray for a blessing. I pray that you would bless Missy and Anthony as they now form a new family, that you would give them an abundance of your love and your faithfulness to see them through the coming years, and that you would strengthen both of them as they join together today in this important step. And so we just thank you for who you are, and we thank you for the love that is here in your name. Amen. All right. Anthony and Missy, I charge you both as you stand in the presence of God to remember that covenant love alone will avail as the foundation of a happy and enduring home. Let Christ, who was loyal to his own unto death, be your example. Let the Apostle Peter be your teacher when he wrote, "Finally, all of you, be like-minded, be sympathetic, love one another, be compassionate and humble. Do not repay evil with evil or insult with insult. On the contrary, repay evil with blessing, because to this you were called, so that you may inherit a blessing. If you keep this attitude of selfless love ever before you, and remaining faithful to each other, resolutely endeavor to fulfill the vows you now will make, God's blessing will be upon you, and the home you establish will endure through life's every change." Anthony, will you have Missy to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love her, comfort her, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for her so long as you both shall live? And Missy, will you have Anthony to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, keep yourself only for him so long as you both shall live?
I do.
Now we're going to do the vows, and I'm going to hold it up so that you people can hear you, okay? So repeat after me.
I, Anthony.
Take you, Missy.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
And thereto.
I pledge you
my faith.
Missy, repeat after me. I'm Missy.
Just for the wind here.
I'm Missy, that's it.
Take you, Anthony.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish. Till death do us part.
According to God's holy ordinance.
I thereto.
Pledge you my faith. Perfect, by the way. Well done. We now come to the point of the service where we exchange rings. One of the wonderful things that we have been given is this wonderful symbol. It's a tradition in our culture going way, way back that you would exchange a ring. And it's a reminder that this is your precious. That's a everybody's joke for you. But it is an important reminder that you are separated from all others, that you're forsaking all others, and you belong to each other, so that even when you're separated, you're always together. So do we have the rings? All right. Anthony, go ahead and take her hand and placing the ring on it. Repeat after me. This ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And steadfast love.
And steadfast love.
Okay. Repeat after me. See, this ring I give you.
This ring I give you.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of our constant faith.
Of our constant faith.
And steadfast love.
And steadfast love.
All right. Would you pray with me? Eternal God, creator and preserver of all mankind, giver of all spiritual grace, the author of everlasting life, send your blessing upon this man and this woman whom we bless in your name, that they, living faithfully together, may surely perform and keep the vows and covenant between them made, and may ever remain in perfect love and peace together, and live according to your laws through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. For as much as Anthony and Missy have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before God in this company and have pledged their faith each to each other and have declared the same by joining hands and by giving and receiving a ring, therefore, by the authority granted to me as a minister of Jesus Christ, I pronounce that they are husband and wife together in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no man put us under. Amen. Anthony, you may kiss the bride. All right, would you please stand for the benediction? Go forth into the world in peace. Be of good courage. Hold fast to that which is good. Render no one evil for evil. Strengthen the faint-hearted. Support the weak. Help the afflicted. Show honor to all. Love and serve the Lord, rejoicing in the power of the Holy Spirit. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. As a minister of our Lord and Savior, and on behalf of the state of Washington, it is my privilege for the first time to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Picciarello.
Today. I promised my beautiful daughter not to embarrass her today, but given my skills as a public speaker, I am sure that promise will not hold up with my delivery of this speech. Seriously though, I would like to first thank Rose Jacobus for her kindness and generosity in allowing her home to be the venue for Missy and Anthony to unite in marriage today. Huge thanks also to the parents of the groom, Steve and Ruth, who are instrumental in bringing things together here. There are a lot of other people who helped make this day happen, and I thank you all. Thank you to all the guests who have made the journey here from both near and far. I also want to reach out to those who cannot come today due to the circumstances of which we all know, but I will not name. We wish you could be here and we miss your presence. Lastly, a moment to honor and remember those who are with us in spirit. I was fortunate enough to be present when Missy came into this world. She was a happy, bubbly baby with very little fussiness. And of course, as she grew, she was cuter than every other toddler in the world. This same cute baby, though, in a few years would discover irrigation hoses and a backyard play hole. She and her friends would turn into a mud pit, overflowing with toys. And did I mention mud? Lots of glorious mud. I used to get in the mud and play with them sometimes, and it was actually a lot of fun. We used to have one of those large, round, above-ground pools. One of my fondest memories of Missy's childhood was using my abundance of body mass to go round and round and round, faster and faster and faster, until we had generated a raging circular current in the pool. Missy would be screaming with laughter and happiness, flying around the pool pretending to be a dolphin or a fish, or just a wonderful, sweet, beautiful young girl. As she got older, I can recall hearing her at piano recitals where she would play with occasional mistakes, but it all sounded like Mozart to this dad's ears. The day we moved her to her dorm at Eastern was a cold, snowy day in January, and I can remember tears welling up when we left her and saw her standing in the doorway, waving to us through the blustery winter weather. That was one of those difficult, yet very happy days for us, knowing that she was spreading her wings towards her future. Pat and I are so fortunate to have Missy as our daughter. Missy is a beautiful, kind, energetic, caring, and nurturing person. We saw early foreshadowing of her future when she would line up all of her dolls in rows and she'd be the teacher for their play sessions. Fast forward to now, and we have a young lady with a degree in elementary and special education, and I am supremely confident she'll be the type of teacher kids will remember as a strong, positive influence early in their lives. She is a well of hope and love and energy, and I'm truly blessed as a father to have her. I love you, Missy. I love you. When Anthony and Missy started dating 6 years ago, it never occurred to me, who is this guy? I liked him right away, and Pat and I have enjoyed seeing him and Missy so happy together. From right off the bat, his presence around Missy and in our home was just normal. I actually looked forward to them hosting pizza and game parties at our house. I knew there wouldn't be any trouble, and I could harass them too. Anthony has a genuine smile, and it is evident from his actions that he has a kind and caring soul. I can't think of a better groom to give my daughter away to. He is a smart, funny, and wonderful young man who is a credit to his parents and whom we are glad to welcome into our family. The best part of all this now is I have someone I can talk science fiction and fantasy movies and video games with. Anthony and Missy, stay true and open and honest to each other in the years to come. And together, you will have the strength to face any challenges life may throw at you. And now, let's raise the glass. To the bride and groom, I wish you all the best that life and love can bring you. Congratulations.
To the bride and groom.
To the bride and groom. Bride and groom.
Cheers. Well done.
Hello. As per usual, I'm going to be the only person up here that didn't write anything down. I like to think that I do my best work when I'm making stuff up on the fly, but that's probably because that's just what I do so often. And unlike the usual. Today, I'm not going to be the longest-winded person up here.
And apparently, for once, I'm not loud enough.
So, I'm going to keep this very short. I'm really happy that all of you could join us. I know that it wasn't easy for a lot of you to get here, and I know that with everything that's going on, it was probably difficult to even decide to come. But we really appreciate having you here, and so this toast is for all of you.
Thank you.
Every word is gold, so let's get it set up.
We want to hear this.
That's right. We got to hear this.
No. That's hard to hear.
That's fair.
If you don't know who I am yet, I'm Ron, the groom's brother. I've been around since Anthony's birth, so no one really knows him better than I do. So naturally, I can tell you a lot about him. He's handsome, he's witty, he's great. Yes. There's a rule, you know. There's a certain bit of wedding etiquette that we guests have to follow. No woman should look better than the bride. No man should look better than the groom. I'd like to thank my fellow groomsmen for abiding by that rule. And I'd also like to thank them for being sober for this event. Being the groom's brother, I have seen him make all manner of bad decisions. From not knowing that Sylvester the cat said suffering succotash, instead mistakenly believing the first three letters were very different, these three letters that he thought they were, they just so happened to turn it into a phrase that is entirely vulgar and would be inappropriate to repeat at a wedding. To marching in the classy chassis parade without playing a note, but instead pantomiming with his trumpet. Of course, everyone here should know there are no mimes in a marching band. Anthony is a great arguer, and he'll never let facts get in the way of a great argument. But no matter what I've said today, or at any point in the past, Anthony, you are my brother, and I will always be with you, probably at your throat, but I will be there nonetheless. I could go on, but I'd rather focus on a great decision Anthony's made, other than having me as a brother, his bride. Missy, I told you he wouldn't say no to homecoming. To all the guests, I want to personally thank you for taking the time to be here today. On behalf of the lovely couple, we're so grateful. There are four women without whose tireless efforts and vision this could not have occurred that I can't go on without acknowledging. Specifically, my mother, Ruth, who took on the task of planning and arranging much of what you see. She did so with a love and passion for this couple that is evident in very exquisite detail. Missy's mom, who both ably assisted and kept an eye on so many of the bride's details, such as that beautiful dress. My grandmother Rose, who graciously offered her home for this beautiful ceremony setting. And finally, the bride, who despite so many changes forced on her by circumstances beyond her control, maintained a remarkably graceful and gracious attitude. She treated her role today not as the center of attention, but rather as that of a certain servant of happiness to others. To the bride and groom's parents, thank you for raising these two amazing people. We're all here to celebrate today. None of our lives would be the same without them, and that's all thanks to you. And lastly, Missy wanted me to thank Anthony for showing up today. Now please lift your glasses for the newlyweds.
Oh my God.
May your joys be as bright as the morning, your years of happiness as numerous as the stars in the heavens, and your troubles but shadows that fade in the sunlight. Now you will feel no rain, for each of you will be shelter for the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you will be warmth for the other. May God bless your marriage today and forever.
Aha!
No fun!
Hello. So for those of you who don't know me, I'm Brittany. I've been best friends with Missy for 15 years now. I've seen her go from being the one who was also playing in the mud with her and getting in trouble for jumping in the pool right after, multiple times. I've seen Missy be really happy, really sad. I've seen her hate me, love me, and I've seen her absolutely despise people and absolutely care for them. The happiest I've ever seen her is when her and Anthony first started dating. I remember having to get ready for homecoming and it taking like 3 hours for her to even figure out what she wanted to do. Hopefully, it doesn't take 3 hours anymore. But I wish you two the best and a forever, a happily ever after. I love both of you very much. Congrats.
Definitely get out enough champagne for all these two.
And then you decide that one.
She's walking on a bottle on the table.
Hi, everybody. My name is Maddie. I've only known Missy and Anthony for a couple of years now, but every single time that I have hung out with them, been around them at all, they've just been the sweetest people in the world. Missy is super loving and kind, and I appreciate everything that she does for other people. And Anthony is this sarcastic, funny, super warm guy, and I can't think of a more perfect couple that we could be celebrating today. So thank you guys for letting me join your friend group and for inviting me to be a bridesmaid today. It was a lot of fun, and I'm so glad for everything that I got to help with in this entire process. So I just wanted to say thank you guys.
Okay, so I just wanted to say that Anthony is somebody I've known for quite a long time, at least since like elementary school or middle school, I think. Yeah, I've just always thought of him as a pretty good friend. We hung out quite a bit through that time period. After high school, we graduated, we went our own ways, and I didn't really talk to him again after that. it was a few years later that I went to Gonzaga University. I attended there for a few years, or for a year. And with COVID breaking out, they had to close down the dorm rooms. And at the time, I didn't have any money. And I just wanted to just show my appreciation for both of them and the other roommates that I've lived with for just letting me in and giving me a place to stay when I didn't really have anywhere else to go so I could continue college. And I think it's that kind of very gracious, friendly, loving attitude that will just keep that relationship going, that marriage healthy and strong, and I really do appreciate them, and I wish the best for them.
Okay, but here's my speech. I want to eat a cupcake. Apparently we get to take a picture together. Yeah. No smashing. This is a rental and this is mine. So, if you don't have a cupcake, you're welcome to go get one. If you've already eaten one, just pretend like you're doing it again.
Oh my god.
Yeah. So, two cupcakes! Two cupcakes!
Two cupcakes.
They both have the same flavor?
Uh-huh.
You're supposed to be medium.
Smash it!
Come on, can you dip it on his nose?
5 minutes to kind of eat and talk, and then we are going to do some dances. So we'll see you slightly over there on our dance floor in like 5 minutes.
Close, hear my thoughts in every note.
for you. Two clear zeros, baby. If I was just another dusty record on the shelf, would you blow me off and play me like everybody else? If I ask you to scrap my back, could you manage that? Let me get you can try me, I can handle that. Furthermore, I apologize for any skipping tracks. This is the last girl to play me, left a couple cracks. I used to, now I'm over that. Cause all the grudges over love is ancient artifacts. If I could only try to know to make you understand, I sing a song to you and grab you by the hand. Keep the stick inside your head like you're dating too. And all my heart's there, be on the only case for you. They crank it higher every time they told you to stop. And all I ask is that you don't get mad at me when you have to purchase Mad D batteries. Appreciate every mix team your friends make. But you never know, we come and go like on the interstate. I think I finally found a note to make you understand. If you can hit it, sing along and take it by the hands. Keep me stuck inside your head like you gave it to. You know my heart's steady, yo, the only place for you.
Like you've been there before.
Go!
My rims never span, to the contrary, you'll find that they're quite stationary. All of my action figures are cherry, Stephen Hawking's in my library. My MySpace page is all totally pimped out, got people begging for my top 8 spaces. Yo, I know pie to a thousand places, ain't got no grill, but I still wear braces. I order all of my sandwiches with mayonnaise. I'm a weird Minesweeper, I can play for days. Once you see my sweet moves, you're gonna stay amazed. My fingers moving so fast, it's like a place I lay. I'm run at Pascal, well, I'm number one. Record calculus just for fun. I ain't got a gap, but I got a soldering gun. Happy Days is my favorite theme song. I can jerk up your butt in a game of ping pong. I'll ace any trivia quiz you bring on. I'm fluent in JavaScript as well as Klingon. All I sing.
Roll on, my segue.
They're cutting us off.